Take Culture. This is Lewis again, once again.
This man with my mouth right here. What's your name again?
Bui Barra.
This man right here makes excellent voice that we're selling right now. As he shows right now, one of his best sellers right now. So if you want to give them more information about the books that you sell, what got you into writing books right now?
Absolutely. Well, the latest title I have right now for my ZBFBooks.com library, that's the website, is Atlanta versus the Mummies of San Diego Valley. It's a Lucha Libre themed book, very much like the old Sandro and Blue Demon movies, where Elida's a luchador, but he's also a crime fighter, so he's got an investigative break-in at the museum. And, it goes on from there. He ends up taking on an Aztec death cult in a death match at their temple.
So I heard that you told me that you have zombies, superheroes, anything about San Antonio, South San Antonio, you have anything that has to do with Texas. What is it? What is the most best-selling that you have, most recent book that they tell you what you had to do?
I'm glad that you brought that up. The three that were great last year that did good was Codename La Lechuza, Texas Assassins, and Sword of the Angel, my other luchador-themed story. Texas Assassins is about a Texas DPS officer who gets captured by a Mexican drug cartel and forced to become a sicario for him. And then the zombie apocalypse hits and it gets pretty violent and crazy after that. Sword of the Angel is about a Mexican luchador. He takes on his dad's mask and he becomes Espada del Angel Jr. But people are kind of disrespecting the mask and he don't want to disrespect his dad's legacy. So he kind of wants to quit, but then the zombie apocalypse hits in San Antonio. And Codename La Lechuza is about the single mom. She takes care of her job at work. She has to deal with, stupid guys and her daughter, but she's also an assassin for a clandestine government organization. And she gets her powers from a curandera that she lives next door to.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, now, once again, it's lechuga, not lechuga, not a... It's not a lettuce.
Codename, right? Lechuga.
Not a lettuce, all right? All right, so what got you into writing books?
Just something to that I enjoyed doing when I was a little kid. I wrote, just kind of grabbed a spiral and would write about, I guess they call it fan fiction these days.
Yes.
I would write about Indiana Jones, Doctor Who, and other stuff like that, Ghostbusters. Just something I always did, and eventually I just kind of started writing. So, yeah, I made it my own.
Was there anything that inspired you, someone who inspired you into writing these books?
Well, I guess, Stephen King, some of the big names, and then some other indie writers like Wayne Simmons and other folks, Ian McKinnon, Joe McKinney, a local author here. A lot of folks that really inspired me to kind of show that I could do it on my own, too.
All right, so what age was the first? What age were you when you wrote your first book? You actually got it.
I might have been 30. Might have been my 30s.
30?
Yeah.
How old are you right now?
I'm 42. My birthday's next week. I'll be 43.
Seriously, I thought you were like at least 20.
Nice. Well, took care of myself, I guess.
All right, so what is, if you want anybody who to read your book, what is the first book that comes to mind that you would actually offer them to read first?
This one's a fun one. Elida versus the Mummies of San Diego Valley. Again, I would recommend that one. But of course, all my books go across different genres. I don't stick to one style. I've got supernatural horror. I've got 80s horror. I've got zombies. I've got weird westerns. Like, of course, Lucha Libre. I've got combat sports. I got a little bit of everything for anybody. If they want to check me out, it's at zbfbooks.com. That's zbfbooks.com. ZombieBloodFights.com, the leader in Tex-Mex exploitation.
Once again, it's 210 Culture signing out. All right, later.